Hey guys, welcome to Nothing Geek TV, and as you can see today I got Lenovo A7000 smartphone with me. The phone is an improvement over A6000, you can call it the big brother of A7000, and the phone got a 5.5 inch HD display. It's a big display, the bottom buttons are non-backlit, so that's a bit of a problem. The build is complete plastic and it's light like the Lenovo A6000. This is the speaker grill. This is the Dolby Atmos speaker. Lenovo has placed big claims about it. We'll be checking it in our full review, so kindly subscribe for that. This is the camera lens. There is no bulge, as you can see, which is a good thing. Volume rocker buttons and power on off buttons. Nothing on the right side. On the top, I got micro USB port and 3.5 mm jack port and a primary mic for voice input. Now if I open the back plate, that reveals to me a big 2900 mAh battery and two ports for SIM card slots. These can be 4G SIM ports. You can insert 4G SIM cards as well, and this is the micro SD card where I have put in a transient 8GB card slot. Great thing. Now let me show you the Antutu benchmark score on this device. So we'll have to test it. So let me run it, and the test will run in the background till things shape up. Till then, I'll show you the amount of free RAM and the storage space available to the user. So guys, you can see the total space is 8GB and 2GB is available. OS is occupying 3GB. So you will need to insert a memory card, and thankfully memory card can be inserted easily. You can unmount it too. Now let me show you the amount of RAM which is available. The phone got 2GB total RAM. And guys, as you can see, it's a Lollipop operating system. It's occupying 0.91 GB of RAM. Apps are using another 200 MB. And I'm getting 773 MB of free RAM, which is not great, but alright, it's fine. We have to see in our full test. Antutu is still running. Let me show you some other stuff till then. The menu is similar like the A6000. And other smartphones, Android use based smartphones. Let me show you the OS. It's Android 5.0 OS and it's Android Lollipop OS, as you can see. Nice device on the first feel overall. It does feel a bit cheap and light to hold, but I'm impressed with the design. If you don't mind the build quality, the screen suffers from smudges, which the A6000 also suffered from, and there's no oleophobic coating, so that is a backdrop. Let us finish with the Antutu benchmark, and I'll show you the score and the multi-touch on this phone. So guys, the phone has been given a score of 41,524. It's unverified because there is no net connection with me as of now. The phone is ranked below S5 and Xiaomi Mi 4, but above Mi 3 and Nexus 5, which is good enough for a really super cheap device. So thanks to the octa-core processor, 41,524 is the benchmark score. Now let me show you the multi-touch on this phone. So it's a 5-point multi-touch on the phone. You can see it clearly, guys. So guys, these were the first impressions. I like this device, but there is more to check. The battery, it's non-removable, whether the phone supports O2G, OTG, A6000 didn't. The oleophobic coating is missing. So there are a lot more stuff which will get revealed in the full review, and of course the gaming review. So kindly hit the subscribe button, and I'll be seeing you next time. Thanks for watching the video.